Claro.
Hello, can you tell me? Yes. Okay. First of all, I would like to clear out something about the specific schedule. It shows that my talk will last 1 hour and a half, and this is not true. My talk will last half an hour or maybe less, and the last one will be at 5 and not at 6. That's all. Okay, well, this talk is about some new updates made to the Windows framework since last year. Based main on these two main new features that are animations and native deployment. Well, this is me. My name is Alvaro Piorno. I am a student at National University of Quilmes, and I am a smalltalk developer at Macap. I will be talking about these main topics. First of all, what is Winter? Here I will give you an overview of what was Winter about and in the state of development it was last year when I gave the previous talk. For them to introduce you to the next topic, that is about the updates. Here I will talk about the new features that I made to Winter since last year, and some updates that maybe they are not features, but like other changes made to Winter during this whole year. Then, in the demo, I will show you a game where the new features can be seen, and if I have time, maybe I will try to debug something to show you how the framework works. And in that point, I will talk about future work, well, the priority are why I will do that new feature. Okay. What is Winter? Winter is a framework to develop games in two dimensions. Here I made emphasis on the word develop because, in my opinion, developer must develop. This may sound very obvious, but in the game development world, it's not that obvious. Because there are another kind of tools, for example, game engines, that not suppose the developer to code too much, like the 8% of the work is like dragging and dropping things, making some configuration, touching buttons, and maybe some scripts for some kind of component. So Winter is not that. Winter is a tool for developers to develop. Okay. It's an easy and also didactic way to create games in Smalltalk. Here I made emphasis on the word didactic, not because I consider Winter a tool for teaching only, but because what Winter provides is a way for the programmer to develop games without taking care about the game structure or the game flow that may be in most of the cases the same to all the games, okay? So you only take care about the logic of your game, and I think that gives Winter, that makes Winter a didactic tool. It is very easy to use, it doesn't have any complex configuration, you only download an empty image, and you install it, you start Winter, and you start developing. No native libraries for now, no extra configuration for the VM, nothing of that. For further information about what is Winter and its origins, or more information about this, you can check My talk for the last year, following this link, you have the slides and also the video of the last conference. These are the current features that Winter has, or at least the most significant. Here, the first four are the ones that were made for the last year, and they were shown last year in La Plata in 2017. So I will not talk this time about them. The new features are the last three. The first one is native deployment. This is about deploying the game on the native operating system window rather than in a more inside the window for more professional games, or I don't know, it's better to have the game running on a window outside the image. Animation, this is a technique of rendering with static sprites, giving the illusion of movement or changes of character. For example, if you can see a character moving before the animation starts. The next one is screen abstraction. This consists of having only one screen with an interchangeable model. So you don't make one screen for each view you have in the screen. So you only have one, and you change what you want to see in the screen. I will extend a bit this feature in the next slide. This update, I don't consider this update directly as a feature, but an important update made to Winter since last year, so I will mention them. First of all, Winter suffered a big change, and it has now a new architecture, mostly on these three parts. The updating and rendering management before was handled by event sending all around the system. Now it's handled by a scheduler in a new process. I made this because there was a lot of some important concepts missing the code, and there was event sending all around, and I wanted to be all handled in one part. This makes it more visible and understandable. Animation management. This is a new feature, so it doesn't have a previous architecture, but it follows the same architecture that before the previous point. It is handled in a scheduler and running on all the animations. Well, now the feature I mentioned before, I want to extend here. The screen abstractions with V models, as I said, it consists on having only one screen with interchangeable models. This model can be an object included in a view model hierarchy. This kind of object knows how to render or take, but it mostly renders with shape. They are thought for the windows like character selection or configuration, etc. Or it can be the game itself. So when you change some of these view models, by the game, you start playing the game. These objects are polymorphic respect of rendering and updating. So that's it. And some go clean up, refactors, and whatever. So much words, blah blah, and now you want to see the game, of course. So, now. First of all, the game I will show was created by Clement Vera, but they recreated it using Winter, having the same result. So for this game, I need one volunteer from the... Anyone? It's a game to play, so...
Come.
Sorry, I will have to change the overview just to we need to see here and also you have to see and I This is just to so you can see now what I was talking about. This is a screen having a view model. This is not the game, this is a view model just showing some widgets. There will be some more, and then we can start the game. So, the two will play by three or four players, but I don't think it would be good in four people here. So, two players. Now, in the season, obviously, winter. Now, here's our character selection. Can you see the characters moving? This is the animation. Now a spell select. It's the same, just a spell. Elena.
Who is who?
I am the one at the right, and he is the one at the left. How what about want to play again? Anyone wants to try it?
Yeah, I'm not sure.
funcionando. Como la web está viendo, para ahí le está cargando. No, tanto no funciona.
What kind of breath per second do you experience, or range per second, sir, do you experience with that framework?
Do you mean about the performance or rendering and like that?
Yeah. Yes.
Well, physics are at this moment simulating the small talk, so I don't consider that performance. As you can see here in the Linux distribution is working well by now. I pretend to later start simulation. To start simulating physics with an active library in C. Before this, they were simulating an active library, but I have too many problems with VM and data, and I prefer to change the at the moment. But in the future, I pretend to be simulating.
Qué bueno.
See, I think that if you try to run this same in Windows, maybe you can experience some kind of slowness, like lag, but it's not lag, it is like not performing. So I don't know if I answered the question.
Yes, sort of. How many sprites can you have in the screen at the same time?
All I want. I don't know if you have a 1 million, maybe the performance will not be the same, but if I can, yeah, you can.
Thanks.
I have a question. Para manejar la animación, ¿tiene, por ejemplo, por 4 puede manejar el tiempo de duración? Quiero, por ejemplo, que muchos juegos tienen ese problema que cuando hacen sprite, que lo hacen en...
¿Podrás repetir la pregunta desde el inicio? Gracias.
¿Se escucha?
Ahí sí.
Mi pregunta es si la animación que por sprite y es manejada por cuadros puede manejar la duración de cada cuadro de forma independiente. Muchas veces tenemos varios motores y programas para hacer juegos que lo omiten, siempre tienen la misma tipo de duración, entonces no es muy entretenido hacerlo así.
I don't know if I must answer in Spanish or
first translate the question.
The question was like if the animation can handle
length,
the sprite frames by some time, or they were shot passing one to the other, and the answer. I'm sorry, but the animations by now and in most of the cases are at like a couple of sprites passing from one to the other in each frame, and that's how. At least in 2D, 3D is very different, but in 2D, the way of making animations, they are not animations here, it's a kind of illusion, and this is made by showing a lot of images like that. One, then the other, así, like that, too fast to make that illusion.
I need to... add more frames for in,
if you want to stay in the same state of animation, you don't increase the index of the animation. You don't have to add the same sprite too much time. I mean, it's like, as I said, it is handled in a scheduler, in a new process, and if you stop, the animation is not running, but in the other process is rendering, so you still can see the character because it's rendering. Then the animation is not running, so the sprite didn't change. If you don't did understand, I will tell you later in Spanish.
Sí, lo entendí. Está perfecto.
Sorry, but I don't have enough time for the demo, so I will not give up this time. But we show you very much. So feature work, timemap, this is not a very important feature, but it's half, it is on the half of development, so I will try to end it. I will not enter in further details because I don't have much time, but it is a kind of a way of kind of intelligent map, just not to use background images or putting elements by hand. There's a lot more that time must provide. For more information, you can check that link. The camera now is the real most important feature, because without feature, at this moment, without the camera feature, elements in the game, if they go out of the vision of the screen, they are lost. And with the camera, you can move and start having another point of the view of the map. The camera also can follow the character as in all kinds of games. And you can also change the perspective of view, like watching the character from front, from top, etc. Well, as I said, a future work is going back to Chikman 2D, that was the original native library for physics, or maybe another network API to create a LAN for online games. I haven't decided yet anything about the implementation. And particle effects, this is a kind of very optimized technique of rendering. This in particular is thought to create some kind of fuzzy phenomena that cannot be easily made with normal technique of rendering or normal animation. An example of a fuzzy phenomena can be bonfire. Sorry, I don't have much time. That's all. If you have any question, you can find me on any break or during the whole small talk, but I will not steal enough time or to Mariano. So that's all.
So, how many Alvaro Piorno exist?
I think I'm the only one.
So, someone
just a question. Have you tested on any other platform? Just one in the Faro or Android, for instance?
Excuse me. I'm not signing you to a bit, so.
Hello?
Yeah.
Does it run? Because I know it is SDL, but does it run on Faro? I know there is a VM, I don't know if it is maintained. for Android, for instance, or for iOS, can you, try running a basic version of this in a mobile operating system?
I really don't know too much of running applications on mobile, how SmallTalk and in. And I honestly didn't try anything about that. By now, Windows only provides to some desktop games. In the future, obviously, some web games. But if I know about something to make that kind of application done, I will try to.
There was a VM for Android, at least, that actually you could just put an image there, an image, and put up as it was a desktop image. You didn't have to change anything, unless you're working with a specific platform feature.
But I think that's...
But I don't know if it is maintained.
I hear about that too, I don't know that. But I think that maybe you must put that in some kind of smaller image maybe and have another considerations.
Okay.